Hello Blazers, it is your boy Roman, your favorite neighborhood Russian, Hagazoon today. Welcome to a brand new video. In today's video, guys, we're going to be reacting to a terrible Russian language speech in Hollywood movies. Before you guys make fun of me for the title of this video, I put Russian reacts to Russians because I'm trying to get new viewers on my channel, okay? Not everybody who watches this video might know that I'm a Russian beforehand, okay? Don't make fun of me. So basically, everybody knows that Russians are a big part of every single Hollywood movie, like ever. And in some of these Western Hollywood films, sometimes these Russian characters that are supposed to be Russian actually speak the Russian language, and it just turns out to be absolutely abysmal. Now, believe it or not, BuzzFeed already has a video about this, but the Russians in the video, their Russian level needs some work as well, to be completely honest.
All right, now I'm gonna demonstrate what actual Russian should sound like.
Это как должно звучить, ты понимаешь?
Я ничего не понимаю.
What the hell was that? This guy's like, I'ma show you what real Russian's supposed to sound like, and then goes like,
Это то, как должно звучить, понимаешь?
Не, чувак, я не понимаю твой русский на уровне персонажа из Call of Duty. So yeah, I just decided that I'm gonna make a video like that myself. The reason why I got this idea is that I've been watching John Wick, me being Russian, I noticed how awful the Russian language in that movie is. So yeah, we're gonna be looking at that, we're gonna be looking at some more classic examples of bad Russian in movies, and yeah, let's get into it. Now, before we really get into this, I would like to tell you guys about the sponsor of today's video, Surfshark VPN. In the current tumultuous climate, things like... Well, one of my lights died, that's cool. In the current tumultuous times, things like privacy and security on the internet are very much at risk. And sometimes even access to the internet and free speech on the internet are things that are targeted as well, and things just get banned left and right. This is why I think that having a VPN is one of the most important things you need to do on the internet today. Surfshark is honestly the best VPN service I've ever used. I've been using it for a few months now. It allows you to protect your online data and also have access to websites that you otherwise would have no access to. Surfshark has a lot of great features. For example, for me, the most beneficial is by far the ability to use it on a multiple amount of devices, on an unlimited amount of devices. Another one that I enjoy is camouflage mode, which is actually a feature that allows you to basically stay hidden and for your provider to actually not know that you're using a VPN at all. You can do simpler things with Surfshark as well. For example, being able to go on Netflix and change your allocation to Canada or America to access shows that you would not be able to see otherwise. So, if you're looking for a good VPN for yourself, then go over to surfshark.deal/NFKRZ and use code NFKRZ at checkout to get 83% off of a 2-year plan and 3 extra months for free. Surfshark makes your entire internet users just much more secure and improves it a lot. And also, if you get it, you support your boys, so that's also pretty cool. So once again, if you're looking for a good VPN for yourself, then go over to surfshark.deal/NFKRZ and use code NFKRZ at checkout and get yourself a sick VPN. Once again, thanks to Surfshark for sponsoring this video, and let's get right into it. Now, before we get to John Wick and all that, I wanted to react to the classic scene and kind of explain it. Everybody knows about this, everybody's seen it. I'm of course talking about the legendary movie Red Heat, where Arnold Schwarzenegger plays a Soviet officer. And I'm sure even if you haven't seen the movie, you've at least seen the scene where Schwarzenegger says, cocaineum.
Cocaineum.
What the hell was that?
Пошли, все вместе.
Почему ты всегда кузин придираешься? Потому что мы такие простые люди.
Oh my god. Oh, it's so bad. Schwarzenegger is actually doing a pretty alright job. This guy though. No. I mean, he's supposed to be Georgian. Georgian people that are from Georgia do have some kind of accent in Russian usually, so they don't sound like actual native Russian speakers a lot of the time, but this is not a Georgian accent, okay? This is nonsense. So what he's trying to say is that he's trying to say почему ты всегда грузином придираешься. But I guess, you know, this actor doesn't know Russian, so he had to learn the phrase by itself, and he's messing up the order of some letters in some words, and he's messing up and he's leaving prepositions out.
Почему ты всегда грузин придираешься?
The word всегда in Russian, which means always. He didn't say всегда, he said всегда.
За это вам и такая лохая. Добыча.
Что будет с нашей страной? Прямо как в старые времена. Мы ж ни в чем не виноваты!
Какие ваши доказательства?
The last guy who said what's your evidence, he actually did a pretty good job. The conversation doesn't even make any sense either.
Какие ваши доказательства?
This guy's pretty good. Classic.
Cocaineum.
Classic, man.
Cocaine.
This scene is actually, I think this is funny because this actually, there's some context about this. You see, Russian language has cases. A word changes depending on its relation to other words in a sentence, its position, you know. The Russian language has 6 cases. So the word for cocaine in Russian is kokain, right? The dialogue in the scene goes as follows. The guy says, какие ваши доказательства? What's your evidence? And Schwarzenegger answers with кокаином. It's not кокаином, it's кокаином. Okay? Basically, the idea here is that Schwarzenegger is responding to a different question. His answer actually makes sense if you change the question. His answer doesn't make sense, it's also stupid, because the question that the guy asks Schwarzenegger does not, like, correspond to the case the response is in. In this scene, a correct response would be кокаин. As far as I understand, originally the question was supposed to be something like чем вы докажете? What can you, like, prove it with? And then Schwarzenegger's character would respond in the instrumental case of the noun saying кокаином, like, what did you do with? What can you prove it with? With cocaine. That's essentially what he says here, with cocaine. And so it doesn't make any sense and it sounds just funny as hell.
Кокаином.
Hopefully I solved that little mystery for you guys there.
Ты что-нибудь хочешь?
Твою сестру? Опять?
Пошел нахуй, мудак.
Dude, I've been telling you, dude, Russian in John Wick is awful. So they arrive to the gas station and one of the guys asks, are you gonna eat something, I guess? He asks it in the infinitive, so he asks, like, are you eating anything at all? The other guy says, your sister? And he responds with, пошёл нахуй, мудак. It just makes no sense. Like, this conversation, it's built on a sentence that's not grammatically correct, so it would not play out in real life like this ever.
Сигареты возьми, блядь.
So he says, go get some cigarettes and be quick, we're running late. I like the usage of interjections, blin and bleh, very accurate, you know, Russian gopniks always interject swear words into the language, very good, that's very good, everything else terrible.
Сигареты возьми, блядь.
This one's fine, he's trying to say сигареты возьми, блин, it's more like
сигареты возьми, блин.
Давай, блядь, быстрее опаздываем.
He's trying to say давай, бля, быстро опаздываем, but he says давай, бля, быстро опаздываем, it's just like... It's once again, they're messing up letters in individual words. It's like Uncanny Valley for me, you know? Like, when I was watching John Wick, I couldn't focus on the movie or take it seriously in any particular way at all because, like, half of the movie is this. What a pain it is to be Russian sometimes.
Oh, I love dogs. Лучше всего сука есть своя цена.
А у этой сука нет.
He says, у всего сука есть своя цена, which is again said very badly, but I'll let it slide, okay? And he puts the word сука, which is in Russian bitch, as an interjection. So it's like, everything's got a goddamn price, you know, that's kind of the vibe of the sentence. And then Keanu, John Wick, responds with, а у этой сука нет. I guess he's talking about the dog because in this scene, like, he's like looking at Keanu's dog and petting it, you know? So I guess the idea is that Keanu flips the interjection of the word bitch, saying that this bitch, you know, the dog, obviously, does not have a price. But again, it's just bad. It's not grammatically correct at all.
А у этой сука нет.
What he was supposed to say is, а у этой суки нет. Again, Russian has cases. You gotta change the word for it to make sense in a sentence, and this just doesn't, and it just... It's funny.
You have good day, sir.
You have good day, sir. We don't speak like that. We don't. And also another thing I gotta point out about John Wick is that John Wick's nickname in the movie Baba Yaga is based on like a Russian folk tale. It's just also stupid as hell because Baba Yaga is like, yes, it's kind of like the Russian boogeyman, but it's like, it's a female character. It's nothing but a female character. I cannot picture any situation in which like a bunch of tough Russian dudes would nickname John Wick, like the toughest guy ever, for a female character from a fairy tale. It's just stupid, man. It's just stupid. There's also this movie called Defiance, which stars Daniel Craig, in which he spoke Russian. Let's check that out.
Когда вою народу еду отпирайте. Это называется помощь трущеников тила фронту.
He's actually doing kind of a good job, but he just messes up. His whole sentence makes sense, but some words he just messes up so bad that it like sticks out as a sore thumb. Hey, he's doing surprisingly well. Shout outs to Daniel Craig, man.
А в нашей социалистической родине ко всем относятся без предубеждений, и к евреям, и к неевреям.
Yo, That's good. Nice job, Daniel. I can understand anything without the subtitles. It's just, yeah, the pronunciation is all over the place. But I mean, what would you expect? I'm not like expecting any high standards from these Hollywood actors. I just want to clarify that. I'm not saying that this movie is awful or, you know, these people are retards because they didn't learn language for, or Russian language for a role. The Russian language is extremely hard. And, you know, that's hella dedication to learn Russian for a role. That's too much. That's like more method than Christian Bale losing and gaining weight and stuff. Okay, there's also this movie in which Jason Statham apparently speaks Russian. Let's check that out. Yeah, of course the guy's name is fucking Vasily, dude.
А ты как думаешь? Это Пётр. Разве меня нет в твоём телефоне?
Полицейский
сводку говорит, что твой телефон не
Wow, that is awful. Honestly, when I look at Jason Statham, I kind of see it. Like, he kind of might pass as a Russian Gopnik if you put him in the right fit and stuff like that. This is Kino. He speaks, like, the words he says are way too proper. He's like, this is not something that a person in distress would say. He's like, я уже несколько часов скрываюсь от полиции. It's like a sentence out of an essay, you know? It's like way too formal, way too descriptive. The language is way too, like, proper, you know what I mean? He'd be like, несколько часов от ментов бегу. I don't know, some shit like that. Not fucking, я уже несколько часов скрываюсь от полиции. It's nonsense. Anyways, guys, I guess that is going to be pretty much it for today's video. If you guys did enjoy today's video, if you guys did find it entertaining, please make sure to slap the like button on it. Maybe I'll make another video like this, maybe reacting to some bad Russian video games or something like that. So that would be pretty fun, I think. And yeah, guys, as well, if you want to support my channel, support what I do on this channel, make sure to go over to the link in the description, to my Patreon, donate to it. I would gladly appreciate it. It helps me out a lot. And yeah, guys, I guess that is going to be pretty much it for today's video. Thank you once again for watching it, and I will see you guys in the next one. Peace.